Wait, can you play City Skylines 2 on the Xbox?
In this video, I'm going to show you how you can play City Skylines 2 on your console right now. As you know, City Skylines 2 has not been released for us console players, and I've made numerous videos about this in the past, but we are still hoping for it to come out natively on console in the future. With that being said, you can actually play the PC version of City Skylines 2 with a controller on your console right now while we wait. To do this, we're going to use something called an NVIDIA GeForce Now to stream the game to our consoles, otherwise known as cloud gaming. You'll need to own City Skylines 2 for this, either on Steam or the Xbox PC Game Store. If you don't already have it, I think it's still around like 50 bucks. If you have an Xbox Game Pass subscription, then you will also have access to the game, so don't pay for it twice. Okay, now that you own City Skylines 2, we can move on to the next step. Go to your console browser. For me on Xbox, that's going to be the Edge browser. If your browser looks like a lower quality than what you would normally see on your TV, that's because the browser might automatically turn on borders around the screen to make sure that nothing gets cut off by your TV. To turn this off and get a full resolution, you're going to want to hit Settings, go down on the list and press System and Performance, then click Hide Border. And then finally check off Apps Can Add a Border. Go back to your browser and voila, you are browsing at full screen. Now that you own City Skylines 2 and you're browsing at full resolution, we're gonna head over to the NVIDIA GeForce Now website and create an account for free. Once you create your account and navigate to the Play GeForce Now page, like this, you're going to go ahead and press the menu button on your controller, click Use Game Controls, and this will allow you to use your controller as it is intended to, with a console, not like a mouse. Then go over to the three lines in the top left corner and hit Settings, go down to Connections, and connect whichever account you own City Skylines 2 on, so that's either going to be Steam or Xbox. Once you're connected, click over to Gameplay, in Settings, and change your mode to Custom. There you'll be able to set your desired resolution as opposed to what NVIDIA thinks you should play, because they always underestimate what your network can actually handle with a very weird resolution. I've got it set to 1080p here because that's what my TV can display. Then you can go back to the games and start up City Skylines 2. Once you're in the game, you can use the controller just fine with the default settings, but of course, you can change all of the keybinds and get a more personalized gaming experience in the input section of the settings. Some minor tweaks I'd recommend is assigning the Enter Photo mode with the View button on your controller. I'd also recommend learning your start and stop times, so pause and unpause, by pressing the left stick down and pressing A, and switching simulation speed by pressing the left stick down and pressing X at the same time. Now, let me show you the basics of how to actually play the game with the settings that it comes with. Once you're into the game, you'll find that
your left stick is for moving the camera around the map, just like you'd expect. The right stick controls your pan and tilt, letting you get those perfect angles for screenshots. The triggers are for zooming in and out. Spend a minute just flying around your city like this. It feels great, and it's one of the reasons I love playing on console. To navigate the main build menu at the bottom, you're going to want to use the D-pad. This lets you quickly select roads, zoning, power, and all your essential services. The bumpers allow you to switch between sections. Now let's get into some building tips and tricks while you're using a controller. Drawing a straight road is easy. Just point and click with the A button or the X button on PlayStation. But the real power comes from the precision tools. See this menu on the side? You're going to want to hit X after you've selected the tool that you wanted, and this allows you to switch between straight roads, curved roads, and even complex parallel roads. To raise and lower your roads for bridges and tunnels, you use the left and right bumpers while you're using the road building tool. This lets you change the elevation step by step. It takes a little practice, but once you get the hang of it, you'll be building complex interchanges in no time. Zoning with a controller is surprisingly fast once you learn the two main tools. You have two options here. The fill tool is probably going to be your best friend. It lets you instantly zone a huge area between roads with a single click. For most of your residential and commercial areas, this is the tool you'll use. For more precise control, you can switch to the marquee tool. This lets you draw a box to specific areas, which is perfect for when you need to fit a small commercial strip into a specific spot. And that's it. Those are the fundamental skills you need to ditch the mouse and keyboard and start building the city of your dreams from your couch. Of course, there are many more controls and keybinds, so if there's something that you don't know how to do, just hit the menu button, go to options, and then input, and you'll see a whole list of controls and keybinds for you to master. But now that you know how to actually play City Skylines on your console, you gotta know how to build a good city. Check out this video to learn some tips and tricks, and I'll see you over there.
What? Are you playing? Wait, what are you doing? Wait, are you playing City Skylines 2 on the Xbox?